Maybe we'll just sit here and listen to the rain. It's very nice here, music to our ears. Now, certainly when we're waking up from our pretense of insanity, really, it's a little irritating, because you look at your life in hindsight and say, wow, I've just been under the spell of insanity. And it can shake up the nerves, and people keep acting, of course, according to insanity. People here worship insanity. The human beings are really just the worshiping of insanity. That's all that it is. And insanity is a pretending, spirit pretending to not be what it is. And what we're caught in is this belief in odds. We've made up something called odds, as if you get enough humans, reflections of insanity, if you get enough of those, odds are that at least one guise of insanity will be sane. This is what we're simply waiting for that to happen. And insanity says, well, you don't want to go against the odds. Odds are that's bound to happen. So I'm seeing all this, and it's just, wow. It is a very, very intense wow, and it's not easy to handle. Other people are heedless of it, but we're waiting, believing that at least one instance of insanity will be sane, simply from odds. 1 in 7 billion must be true. We think that odds must be true. But the fact is, there is no guise of insanity that is ever sane. Not one, ever. There's no such thing as odds when you're dealing with truth. Truth is not at the mercy of odds. Truth is not at the mercy of numbers. And it's insanity to think so. So, very intense time right now, in the world, to say the least. As we get to this breaking point where people will just continue to play what they think the odds are in their favor, and the odds are not in their favor at all. Odds are never in favor of the truth. All truth is true, and no lies are ever true. This is the fact. There's no odds involved whatsoever. So if we keep playing the odds, we are bound to lose. It's 100% certain that we will lose, and yet we're so caught up in quantification and numbers and odds and gambling and all this. It's not a just circumstantial that when religious tradition starts to crumble, that people get more and more into gambling. And this is one of the things that's prohibited by most religious traditions, is gambling. Because it's playing the odds, and the purpose of a true religious education is that there are no odds with God. There are no such thing as odds at all. All of us are perfect. We all have perfect standing in reality. There's only reality. All light is perfect, 100% pure light. There's zero odds in reality. All of truth is true. And there's no odds whatsoever that could be different at all. So there's no gamble whatsoever. The extent that gambling has permeated culture now is simply extraordinary, and it's a sure-fire, telltale sign of how terrible civilization has become, actually. We are now cavalier about the extreme symptoms that indicate great degeneracy in our will towards truth and falling into self-deception more and more and more. Cavalier, we just brush the symptoms aside and say, oh, that's great, that's good. It's like as if fear is the escape from fear. The escape from fear would be doubling down on fear. So it's alarming. The alarm bells are going off. I mean, the world is absolutely alarming. We're not insane, but we are caught up in insanity, which is pretense. We're pretending to be insane. We're caught up in this pretending to be insaneness. So we're caught up in insanity. But spirit cannot be insane, of course. Not actually. But it can get caught up in this pretending to be insane, for sure. And it has done so. It's got caught up in this. So we're certainly caught up in insanity. This world to a terrible degree. And any suffering at all, the fact is we're suffering from insanity. We're suffering from insanity. We're not insane, but we're suffering from insanity. Okay, this is a better way to put it, I believe. We're not insane. Spirit's not insane, but it is suffering from insanity. Suffering from a pretense. Yeah, we're getting a little rain here. Finally, after 4 years, a little rain. An inch or two. And the meteorologists are screaming, here it is, El Nino, the monster, the Godzilla, Goliath is coming. And just a little bit of rain. Hyping it like crazy. Then some showers, you'll have some showers, a little hundredth of an inch, 500ths of an inch tomorrow, next day. That's nothing. It's nothing. We're all waiting for El Nino to strike, and the world is waiting for insanity to not cause suffering. They're waiting for someone who's suffering from insanity to not suffer from insanity. To be insane but not suffer from it. It's not possible. The odds on that are 0.000000. Insanity is suffering. Everyone who's suffering to even the tiniest bit is suffering from insanity and nothing else. And they're just inviting everybody else to wait with them until the impossible happens. That's insanity. Waiting for insanity to be true is insanity. And inviting others to wait with them is insanity. So as all this dawns, it becomes clearer and clearer. I'm seeing more and more adamantly that, hey, look at this, look at this, notice this, notice this. Wait a minute here, just not so fast, insanity. And I realize my entire life's been ruled by this monster, totally against my best interests and what I really want. Insanity is a ferocious foe, it seems to be. And yet there's really nothing there at all. It has no power whatsoever. That's why it's so ferocious. It doesn't want us to find out it has no power. And its ferocity comes from our continuity fear. That's what fuels it. You know, fire has to have fuel. The fire of insanity is fueled by continuity fear. The more we evaporate continuity fear, the less the fire of insanity has, and the fire begins to go out. So it's important to keep getting comfortable, with the light, commit to the light, which is what we are. We are the light, the truth. Get used to sanity. Get used to representations of sanity. Get used to that. And also have a little humor, of course. I sometimes try to throw something a little bit different in the videos. Just to realize we're not trying to be smart. We're shifting to genius. Genius is sanity. There's no aspect of sanity that is insane, just as there's no aspect of insanity that is sane. So as soon as we admit, try to say that there's some aspect of insanity that's sane, the corollary is we'll believe that there's some aspect of sanity that is insane, and then we'll try to figure out, how do I get rid of that? There's nothing to get rid of. Just drop the falsity that there's some aspect of insanity that's sane, and you'll realize, oh, all of sanity is sane. There's nothing I need to do to fix it, make it better, get rid of something, clean it up. Nothing. I don't need to clean anything up. I spent the day cleaning up terrible, dirty, on my knees, vacuuming, dust. Yeah, that's how I spend my day. Not too happy about it. Every day I spend time cleaning up for insanity, who tells me that I'm really just cleaning up sanity. Sanity doesn't need any cleanup. Sanity doesn't need any cleanup. So, of course, I'm very displeased with insanity and how it tries to arrogantly govern my life and everyone's life. This world is arrogant beyond belief, or arrogant into belief. Belief is arrogance. That really, to most large extent, we can give a different purpose to belief, to get free of arrogance, and that's not arrogance. So the light, the light, the light, the light, the light. Commit to the light. To say, I am committed to the light. I am committed to the light. There's not any aspect of the light that isn't light. Okay, this is very important to realize. There is no aspect of the light that is anything other than light, pure light. All light is pure light. All light is pure light. Even light pretending to not be light, electromagnetism, it's still pure light. So commit to the light. Commit to the light. And as you do this, you'll start coming out of this spell that insanity has cast upon us. fueled by our continuity fear, afraid that we don't know how to function in reality anymore. Maybe reality has changed. Maybe we can't. There's this fear of perfection, fear of our own true nature, fear of the light. We're so used to electromagnetism, that we're afraid of the light, continuity fear. There's nothing to fear about the light. All light is 100% pure light. This is what we need to experience, that all light is 100% pure light. Just hang out with the light. Hang out in the light. Hang out as the light. There's nothing we need to do to purify it. There's never been any light corrupted or tainted. No part of the light is not the light. No part of sanity is insanity. Not any. Not even the tiniest, tiniest speck. So, stop playing the game of ought. Stop gambling on insanity. Because in doing that, you'll simply find yourself in a world with 7 billion people all struggling to survive and saying, though, this is my life. This is where I want to be. This is where I have to be because I'm playing the odds. And the more people there are, the better odds there are. And then we have all these troubles with too many people. And so here we are. This is because we've been playing the odds. There are no odds to play. And we think if we accept truth, we'll forget how to gamble successfully. Well, there is no gamble. There's nothing to gamble on. There's nothing to gamble on. An absolute sure thing is not gambling. My life has been terrible because smartness hates me. And yet, I haven't been able to get free of smartness, so it pushes me down and tries to isolate me. Smartness is very frightened of genius. Just insanity is very frightened of sanity. So all this information brings about a sense, a wowness in us, a very strong wowness. We just need to breathe into it. When you recognize the wow, sometimes you'll feel you just take a deep breath naturally, like, oh wow, okay, good, I've reconnected with the wowness. I was struggling a little bit. It's just the wowness, that's all. That's all that it is. It's a positive. It's great. It's tremendous. I was able to make the last video. At this point, I'm not sure what I'm going to title it, but It's a lot of work, to say the least, and it actually, the whole thing rendered, and usually it doesn't, but it took about 15 hours, I'd say, maybe, to render. A lot of work, but was able to do it. It was very exciting to do it. Very, very exciting. It's a higher intensity that we're throwing everything we've got now into this battle, really. And the battle is to recognize that there is no battle, that sanity has no battle to win. Only insanity has the battle. It's battling to not suffer, to be insane but not suffer. That's the battle. Whereas reality has no battle at all. It's completely sane. There's no suffering whatsoever. It's not battling to cause to be sane and suffer at the same time. It's not battling for that, actually. Well, what we're doing is battling for that. But when we pretend, give up this attempt to change reality, we won't be struggling. There's no struggle. Reality doesn't have any struggle. Sanity doesn't have any struggle. It's only insanity that has a struggle, inherently so. To struggle is insanity. Insanity is to struggle. In some way, we're all struggling, aren't we, here? You look at the celebrities, the pretty people, they're struggling terrible, aren't they? The business people, constantly searching. To search is insanity. What are we searching for? Truth isn't searching for something. It's not searching for some aspect of truth that isn't true. There's no search. It's insanity that's searching for some aspect of insanity to be true and therefore not suffer. That's the seeking. That's the searching. Give up the search. Call off the search. We don't need to be seeking for that, do we? And we think, well, if we're not searching and struggling and searching, we won't find. There's nothing to find. Insanity is looking to find some aspect of insanity that is sane and is not suffering. Therefore, there's no aspect of insanity that's sane. And truth, sanity isn't searching at all. Doesn't need to. It's all sane. It knows that it's sane. There's no need. What could it search for? So there's no search. Call off the search, and that's it. We don't need to be experts in the search and in searching. Yeah, we search for a job, we search for relationships, we search. This whole world is based on searching, is it not? Search for food, search for shelter, search, search, search. That's insanity. Reality doesn't need to search for anything. We're trying to become experts in searching. And so we play this out through bodies who supposedly have needs that we projected upon them, and then struggling to survive and reach those needs by searching, searching. We're all searching constantly, searching for the next deal, next something. Reality is not a searcher. There's no need to search at all. Now we hear this. But just hear it and experience the wow. That's it. That's all you have to do. You don't have to say, oh, great, this is going to help my search. There seems to be some part of insanity that's sane. No, no part of insanity is sane. Whatever I'm saying that's sane is coming from sanity, not from insanity. There's nothing, we don't have to rid sanity of anything. So all of it is sane. All of it. And so we're just hearing this, and it has its effect. Thinking it is one thing. Hearing it is another. Saying it, speaking and hearing it is a stronger effect. And then being in the pure silence of it is even stronger effect. Because there the certainty is absolute. And it's given evidence by just the silence. There's no reason sanity doesn't need to defend itself. It cannot be attacked. It cannot be harmed. It cannot be changed. There's nothing it needs to protect or defend. There's no part of sanity that can be anything but sanity. There's no suffering in it at all. Inherently so. This is all inherently so. So you get Ramana Maharshi giving the highest kind of testimony to truth through his silence. Now, it's not the only testimony that can be given, but you could say it's of the highest variety. That's what he said. It is very, very potent. It's the most potent. This intense silence, this very calm but intense, positive silence. So just coming across those who are giving great testimony to truth, to sanity, is very helpful for our continuity fear. Very, very helpful. And we say, oh, okay, that's it. Okay, maybe I can be that way too. Yeah, why not? I commit to the light right now. I fully commit to the light right now. I fully commit to the light right now. Because there's no part of sanity that isn't sane. So what are we waiting for? What are we waiting for? When we glimpse sanity, we realize what have we been waiting for? there's no reason to wait at all. Waiting, we were playing the odds, weren't we? That insanity was telling us, play the odds. You'll be smart. The smart money is on the odds. Well, smartness is insanity. All of truth is true. All of truth is true. All of truth is true. This is the primary recognition. All of truth is true. And this is what will give us vast relief when we can accept this. It's like we'll be plunged into relief. Like an ocean of relief. A vast ocean of relief. Imagine this vast ocean, and it's 100% relief. Relief from suffering, from all suffering. All of truth is true, yes. So, it's not a little thing to be hearing this. It's tremendous. It's more tremendous to take all the entertainment in the world that's happening right now, this day, all the entertainment, put it all together, and it can't even come remotely close to just hearing this, that all of truth is true, and plunge into the ocean of relief, this vast ocean of relief where there's no suffering, and abide in that vast ocean. Take all the news, all the education, all the entertainment, all of that. It cannot stack, it cannot even add up to anything compared to simply hearing the simple truth. So we're spending our time wisely here, very wisely. Proving to ourselves that we can pay attention to this. This is what we really want. We want the relief from suffering. All of truth is relief from suffering. There's no aspect of truth whatsoever that isn't relief from suffering, perfect relief from suffering. All of truth is perfect relief from suffering without any exception. Everywhere is relief from suffering. Now is perfect relief from suffering. Everywhere. Here is perfect relief from suffering. Here is everywhere. Now is every is all is always. Here is always. All of reality is perfect relief from suffering. All of sanity is perfect relief from suffering. There are no degrees. There are no degrees. There are no degrees. This is why it's just clear. Continuum, the smoothed out continuum we will abide in. Where abidance is this smooth continuum. There are no levels or degrees of relief from suffering. It's all perfect relief from suffering. We hope this is just the beginning of El Nino. It's starting off, very well behaved. yeah. Which is good. Which is good. There's just been a gradual acceleration from November through December and now into January of a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more precipitation. So it's just, that's great. It couldn't be better as long as it keeps accelerating. And we get, you know, a storm that brings in 10 inches and one that brings in 20 inches. We need like about 100 feet of snowpack in the Sierras, actually. Let's get 100 feet this year. Or 200. Some places can get a lot. Just pack it, pack it, pack it, pack it. And then in the spring, let the rain come on that snowpack and massive amounts of rain so the moisture content of the snow becomes astronomical. That's what we really need. Of course, that's all most likely a moot point, the way the world is headed. The gamblers. Well, on a pirate ship of gamblers. But not for long. We take refuge in truth, in sanity, in the now, in the here, in the now, in the no levels. All truth is 100% true. There's no levels of truth. All truth is 100% true. There are no levels of truth. There's no guise of insanity that is sane. No matter if the guises are infinite, there's never going to be a guise of insanity that is sane. So give up looking at all the guises. Stop searching among the guises. Nice rain. This is what we're looking for. It needs to just keep raining like this for the next 3 months. let's everyone just go to the desert and just let the rest of the, let it snow, like the, you know, just stack up the water. This is indeed music to our ears, wonderful music. We have been in a terrifying scenario in California. People think living in California is so wonderful. It's been terrifying. These droughts are terrifying for us. The El Nino of 84 broke a 10-year drought. And we let everything die, and you don't know if it's ever going to rain again. And now we have, how many, 2 or 3 times more people in the state, which is insanity, because this California is pretty much scrubland and desert, especially Southern California, but it cannot really handle that many people, not remotely. And so you get the earthquakes here, you get the fires, the terrible wildfires, you get the terrible droughts. You get a lot of terrible things in California, actually. It goes on and on and on. Terrible crowding, terrible loss of culture, the loss of so much that used the way of life, etc. But so it's awful living here. And this last one, if it's not going to rain heavily this winter, we are in catastrophic situation, and we may, you know, people may have to leave the state. I don't know what would happen. It's like the end of California. And we are so spoiled here. We're ruined. I can't imagine living anywhere else, actually, really. It just seems impossible. So the next step from California is to step into the refuge of sanity, which gives perfect immunity from all suffering. All of it does. There's nowhere where we can go in sanity that isn't a perfect refuge from suffering. So that's the next step. We reached a level of civilization and lifestyle in California that I believe is the highest in the history of this world. And yet it still was full of insecurity and vulnerability and suffering and misery and all of that. I mean, the last 4 years, the weather has been maybe the best weather that the planet's ever experienced. It's been absolutely astonishing the last 4 years. Every day a jewel. I just soaked it up. And I say thank you, because it gets us ready for what? Stepping into sanity. It does. Because it's perfect refuge from all suffering. There's not even a possibility that a day could dawn which isn't perfect, so to speak metaphorically. But there, every moment is a jewel, and there's no possibility it could be otherwise. and there's no suffering engaged with it at all. But we went as long as we could go in California with this jewel-like weather. So that was enough. We have to get the rain this year. But in driving around today, I realized, maybe it was yesterday I was driving, that as much as we like the rain and we need it, I miss the perfect days. I mean, last year, at this time, it was probably like 80 degrees in January. I mean, it was like summer in January. It was perfect. It was gorgeous. It was just stunningly gorgeous. So I do miss that. And I talked to some other people. They do too. They say, yeah, I do miss it. I miss the perfect weather. There's no question. So we are completely spoiled, which is great. It's good to be completely spoiled. And then recognize, wow, I can't go back to the way, you know, to insanity, the suffering of insanity. I can't go back to that. There's just no way. There's just no way. Once you get a taste of sanity, for instance, you can't go back, really. You cannot. And the good life that people had out here, wow. I mean, it's being ruined in a lot of ways. If you're not super wealthy, your life is going to get pulled down. And just everything about it. And so, you can't go back. You cannot go back. Gracious living. Once you've experienced gracious living, you can't go back to gangster culture. You cannot. So I don't know what everyone's thinking out here, but if they have any wisdom at all, they would be looking for truth. They'd be looking for sanity. Of course, a lot of people come out to California from different places in the world, and they become very spiritual because they soak it up here, and then they go back to the other places they used to live and travel on, and they say, wow, I want that feeling I was getting in California. I don't want this. I become very spiritual. How do I stay happy all the time? There's a lot of people, a lot of spirituality in California comes from people who come here from other places and just, wow. They get off on the vibe and say, wow, I don't want to go back to anything less than this. How can I have this all the time? Yeah, it's similar to Hawaii too. You get that same sort of feeling, but California's a little different because we have the spaciousness here. It's just the days feel spiritual. If you really look at the day, you can feel it. You just say, wow, is this a dream or is this real or a dream? What is this? And experiencing the, like I said, the gracious living, where there's just very little crime, no concern, nobody locked anything. I mean, we just everybody felt comfortable and safe, and wow, we're just all just loving this life here, and to go down from that, it's just no way. You know the difference now. You know the difference. They say ignorance is bliss. I mean, when you have nothing to compare your suffering to, you just keep suffering. And you say, well, this has got no choice. But when you experience something better, you say, hey, wait a minute. I don't want to, there's something better. I don't want to go back down into that, right? So when we experience sanity, the experiences we have with it, there are times when the Holy Spirit helps me so much that I'm in this mode of just very clear sanity, and I say, "Wow, this is what I really love. I don't want this to diminish at all." And when it starts diminishing because of the pull of the world, it's terrible. I say, this is awful. I don't want, how can I prevent this from diminishing? So this has been my lifelong quest. How do I prevent this from diminishing? And we're, you know, in high-speed pursuit right now, to say the least. Truly knocking on heaven's door, truly. More than that. I'm not going to start over with civilization and try to build it up again. Are you kidding? That's been hell. That's insanity. So, this is it. This is it. This is it's abidance or bust, you know, completely. So, there's an intensity here in it. I do sometimes get irritated because it just, I say, hey, Holy Spirit, more help, come on, more cowbell, let's put all the cowbell we can in this. This is all out go time right now. We are in all out go time mode now, as we expected. So, we're fine. I expected it. And so I'm fine with it. Ah, to lighten the mood up a little. Well, we've been lightening up so much, you might say, to ease off the lightening of it a little bit. I found, wow, it's been a very, very intense day. I'm on edge because the progress is just so intense. I discovered positivity has been off the charts today. My gosh, I discovered a couple of things in terms of switching over to exercise and recreation and things like that, mundane stuff, but it reflects something. And I got back the mobility I used to have in my golf swing, taking the backswing real high and then past horizontal towards the ground, wrapping it that far. That flexible, and then bringing it through, and I was able to do that beautifully. I said, oh my gosh, that's how I swung when I was young. The fact that I got back this extension, this incredible extension on my swing, I was just astonished. 4 months ago, I had a completely frozen shoulder. I couldn't even move my arm. Couldn't hardly do anything with my arm at all. And now I've got this full extension like I did when I was young. I just was so delighted. I didn't know what to do with myself. Wow. So all this flexibility, weight loss, everything is suddenly, I said, let me try this, and oh my gosh, I can do it. So I went into some sort of wow shock over that, to say the least. Then I went over to the jump rope, and suddenly I said, why don't I try the two jumps in between each swing of the rope? So you're going hop, 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 hop. Hop, 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 rope, hop, hop, rope, hop, hop, rope. Instead of hop, rope, hop, rope, hop, rope, hop, rope, hop, hop, rope, hop, hop, rope, hop, hop, rope, hop, hop, rope. I did that. I did that really well. I said, wow, what a great exercise that is. The double hop between each turn of the rope. Loved it. Loved it. Loved it. Very intense. Very intense. And I discovered that being on the balls of our feet, like I said, being on your toes, being on the balls of our feet, this is real athleticism. Balls, it's, oh yeah, I remember that. Be on the balls of your feet, not flat-footed, not on your heels. But we don't realize we can move on the balls of our feet. We can balance on the balls of our feet. We have this capability. Yeah, also, I stepped on the foam roller I have and with my feet, and I stood on top of it, and I was balancing on it. It was a tremendous balancing practice. I said, wow. So I discovered like these three different exercises today that just sort of like rejuvenated me and revitalized and saying, hey, I'm getting back to youth almost in some ways. Wow. All this effort. Now, here's the thing. It's very important to realize that when we're practicing, don't worry about applying it. When I'm doing all these flexibility exercises, stretching, turning, stretching, and swinging this way, and just trying to keep getting more and more flexible and limber, I'm not thinking exactly how am I going to apply this if I'm playing golf on, you know, technically, exactly. This freezes you up. And then you don't say, well, if I don't know exactly how this is going to be applied and what the result is going to be, blah, 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 then I should, why am I doing this? Why am I practicing? Why am I stretching? This is, of course, insanity. Of course, I know when I'm getting more and more flexible, it's going to have a positive effect. It has to. I don't have to quantify it, worry about quantifying it. It'll be what it is. So just that's having faith. Is just a genius. Having faith is genius. So when we think about spiritual path, we're hearing this, say, well, now exactly when am I going to be enlightened, and how's enlightenment going to be, and how am I going to apply enlightenment, and this and this. This is insanity. It's moving us. It's evaporating our continuity fear. And however that plays out, it will play out, but it will be much, 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 much greater, better than right now. Just like I knew when I was working on this flexibility, I said, at some point, you know, I'll recognize there'll be a payoff from this, for sure. And here it comes. And still, I said, well, I don't know how that's going to play out, but I don't care. I'll just keep working on it. Keep stretching. I'm enjoying it. I'm seeing light at the end of the tunnel. Why do I have to quantify exactly when I'm going to get out of the tunnel? What am I going to do? What are this, and that? Or else I'm going to quit? What is that? That's insanity. And so we allow insanity to block our practicing, is what we do. So I just keep piling on the practice, spiritually, flexibility-wise. I just keep piling it on. I keep, like jump rope, for instance. I just keep doing as much as I can. What's the payoff? I don't know. But I'm sure there will be one. It's better than not doing it, that is for sure. I'm not worried about quantifying the payoff. When you worry about more about quantifying the payoff than practicing, this paralyzes us. Don't get caught up into quantifying. Because as we remember, this world, insanity is playing what it thinks of the odds, and there are no odds. So ultimately what this pays off in is recognizing there are no odds. So it pays off in perfect freedom from suffering, ultimately. It has to. We don't need to quantify when is that, because again, that's going back to gambling, playing the odds, like as if, well, there's some variable involved. There's no variable in truth. Truth is not variable. Truth is not variable. Truth is not variable. There's no variance in sanity. There's no variance in sanity. There's no variance in sanity. There's no sanity doesn't variate. It doesn't fluctuate. There's no variance in truth. There's no variance in truth. There's no variance in truth. Truth does not variate. Truth does not variate. Truth does not variate. So that's why we can experience all of truth right here, right now. It does not variate. So we can experience all truth right here, right now. We can abide in truth right here, right now. We can experience the perfect relief from suffering right here, right now, because truth does not variate at all. That's why Ramana Maharshi could sit still like he did. There's no variation taking place at all. He was confident. He knew of this. He knew this. He knew this. So he knew the truth as he was experiencing, the same truth that we can experience. Any place, any time. Anywhere, any place, any time. Right now is the only time there is for truth. Isn't that so? Since there's no variance at all in truth, this moment is the only time there is for truth. There's no variance in truth. There's no variance in truth. There's no variance in truth. It's all true. Always. Truth is always true. Truth is always true. Truth is always true. Now we can hear this and hear this and hear this and just keep hearing. It's like skipping rope. It's like skipping rope. Practicing spiritual practice is like skipping rope. Jump rope. You just keep doing it. And one day you might have you may just hop. Hop into it. You know. You may be walking down the road. And you might say to yourself, I'm on my toes. I'm on the balls of my feet. This is really walking. I'm really walking. I wasn't walking before. This is really walking. I'm dancing. I'm dancing down the street. Life is a song. It's just, wow. Now this happened to me. I was in the market, grocery market, last week, I believe. And they were playing these songs from the oldies, 60s, whatever. It's a really great songs. They have some great songs they play in there. And I started walking to the music, kind of walking in different ways. And I just got all these different ways of walking to it in the aisles of this grocery store. People probably look at me, what in the world is he doing? But I was able to move. I was moving. I was moving with the music. Before, I would just be shuffling along, schlepping along like a stone, like a rolling stone, schlepping along. But now I was turning and pivoting and moving and up on the, you know, just like, I said, wow. I was like a kid. And it just happened. It just happened. I don't know. I didn't plan it or anything. And so, yeah, today I did a lot of jump rope and my legs feel tired. And tomorrow I'll try to do a lot more. And next day and try to do more and just keep jumping rope. One day I'll be dancing down the road. And it's all because I was just hop, 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 jump, hop, hop, jump, hop, hop, jump, hop, hop, jump. And so here we are spending time, hop, hop, jump, hop, hop, jump. Hearing it over and over and over and over and over. And one day, it'll be easy for us. You say, oh, I get it. I get it. So we'll dance on down the road, the eternal road of bliss. We'll be dancing on down that road. And the others will be gambling on insanity. We'll be gambling on insanity. That doesn't make us happy at all. We have to recognize this is what they're doing. And what a trap that is, isn't it? Because we say, well, this is how they gamble. They say, well, the more planets they discover, the more they gamble. They say, oh, wow. You mean, okay, so there's no insanity on this planet that's sane, but we're discovering millions and millions of other planets in the universe. There's certain to be some form of insanity that's sane on one of those planets. We got to go discover and find out where it is. And so you see the trap? You see the trap of gambling? The gambling trap, gambling on its insanity, how it's such an extreme trap and how it's so dangerous right now because we're discovering all these other planets. And we say, hey, we could grow more people there. Wow. And the odds, we think the odds are in our favor now. The odds are getting more and more in our favor. So the problem with the technology has been this belief that they're helping turn the odds in our favor. This is the feeling we've gotten. Like, yeah, the odds seem to be turning in our favor finally. Wow. We can find a way to have more and more people in the world, more and more healthy people in the world, and then send them to other planets and colonize those planets, and wow, the odds are increasing in our favor more and more and more and more and more. No, there are no odds. There are no odds. There are no odds at all. And this is a drastic problem with this technology that has come into this world. And why religion and wisdom is spiraling down the out of control, down the drain. As we're getting pulled into this belief in the odds. Oh, there are some odds. Maybe the odds can... No, there are no odds. There are no odds. There are no odds. There are no odds. There's only the evens. The evenness of truth. The invariable truth of truth. The invariable truth of truth. The smoothness of smoothness, the invariable smoothness of smoothness, the invariable spaciousness of spaciousness. And all of that is right here, right now, because it doesn't variate at all. We don't need to wait on it for some change that would be more, that are, put the odds in our favor more. There are no odds. It's perfect certainty. Perfect certainty. There's no odds in perfect certainty. There's no variance. How could there be odds? Truth doesn't variate. There's no levels to truth. All of truth is 100% true. All of light is 100% light. We'll be living on Easy Street, that is for sure. No variance. So we look around, no variance, no variance, no variance. We don't need to move. We don't need to go anywhere. We don't need to defend. We don't need to be on the alert for variance. Or where, okay, where's the what direction the variance is going to come from? Better build a fort in that direction. How do we muster our resources? How do we get others to help control them so they can fight off the variance? There's no variance. Look in every direction. Look in every window. What do you see? The hollies. Where do they go? Going down the road. On highways and byways. Yeah. Look in every direction. Look in every direction. No variance. 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 Don't need to be vigilant. On alert. For variance. Perfect refuge from suffering. This is not a joke. We're not dealing with jokes here. We're completely serious here. We absolutely can abide in it. It's right here and right now. We just have to stop waiting. That's all. Call off the search. Give up the search. Stop waiting. Stop searching. Stop searching. Stop waiting. Stop searching. Stop waiting for the odds. Stop searching for what doesn't exist. Stop searching for what need not be found. We don't need to iron out any wrinkles of truth. Truth doesn't have any wrinkles to it. Nothing we need to do, therefore. No wrinkles we need to iron out. Right here, right now, this is true, this is true, this is true, right here, right now. Stayed up late last night. I was up to 1:30 in the morning finishing that video. A lot of work. And I took a rest for an hour this afternoon because I was tired. So this is how I've always pushed it in my life. I'll keep working until I finish something. I don't care if I have to stay up all night. Strike while the iron is hot. And you can see why I've been so serious and intense in my life, because I realize this is coming. This belief that the odds are turning in our favor is the worst self-delusion of all. This is what we have to avoid. This is the heart of delusion. The odds are turning in our favor. We're getting more technology, more gadgets. We think this is helping improve my odds. That I'll come across some form of insanity that I'm content with, that I truly want, that there's no suffering to it, that is sane, that I'll come across that eventually. No. That's a fool's errand. We've sent ourselves out on a fool's errand. No question about it. We sent ourselves out on it. God did not send us out on this fool's errand. So we can retract that errand. That fool's errand. Simply retract it. Walk it back. That's all. Again, there's no necessity to it. God did not tell us you must go on this fool's errand. Find some part of his insanity that's sane. No, God did not send us on that. So there's no necessity to it. Our being is not going to be affected because there's no necessity to it. So we're not going to produce variance by ending the search. No variance, no ripple will be produced in reality. No variance at all. We're not going counter to reality by walking back a fool's errand. Is it still raining or is it just dripping? Maybe it's just dripping. That's fine. So the danger of these times is off the charts, where we get tempted once again by odds, to believe in odds. And so many have gone, are circling the drain right now. They don't have to, if they can. Well, I'm doing everything I can do at this, right at this moment. I'll keep working, doing to do better. I would want everyone in the world to watch these videos, actually. Everyone just suffering from this fool's errand we sent ourselves out on, and on a whim. Just for the heck of it, just to see what would happen. It's certainly nice to have these sound effects here. I'm enjoying it. Of course, we always have sound effects. On nice days, the kids are playing and cars are going and it's all sorts of sound. Walking people, joggers, walkers, everything. Right now, it's just the drip, drippity, drip, 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 pop, pop, pop. Gurgle, gurgle, but it's wonderful. So by all means, listen to these videos, watch the videos, listen to the videos, my gosh. This is on point, it's on point. It's very much on point, I feel it. This is on point. We know the truth is right here. We're on point for that. It's right here. It's right now. It's right here. It's right now. It's invariable. We're bringing to light the entire matrix of a fool's errand here and recognizing it as such. And it seems like uncharted territory for us, yeah. But that's okay. We're good navigators. We're navigating ourselves into this safe harbor, this refuge of nowness, of truth, of no odds, of no variance. We're navigating right into this safe harbor. Just in time here. I mean, we don't want to postpone this. And the more we see that this is what we need to be doing, the more shocking it is what the world is up to, how they spend their time. The more devastatingly shocking it is to see it. To say, holy cow, if not by the for the grace of God, I would be spending my time in that way. And that's a real shocker. That's part of the thing that's very difficult to deal with, really. For me, I get... Wow. It's like you're going back from the pit and then you see the pit for what it is. You say, oh my gosh. I was on the edge of that pit. We still have to keep our cool. We still have to stay in the wow. Just stay in the wow. Stay intrepid. Still have to stay intrepid. Still have to stay intrepid. But at some point here, we turn away from the pit entirely, commit to the light, commit to truth, commit to the invariance. Commit to the invariance. Commit to the invariance. And that's it.